Daily morning prayer. Monday, November 6th, 2023. I was glad when they said unto me, "We will go into the house of the Lord." Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess. Restore all those who are penitent according to your promises, declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for the same, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. O come, let us adore him. O be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. O come, let us adore him. I will magnify you, O Lord. For you have lifted me up, and have not let my foes triumph over me. O Lord my God, I cried unto you, and you have made me whole. You, Lord, have brought my soul out of the grave. You have saved my life from among those who go down to the pit. Sing praises unto the Lord, O you saints of his, and give thanks unto him for the remembrance of his holiness. For his wrath endures but the twinkling of an eye, his pleasure for a lifetime. Heaviness may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. In my prosperity I said, I shall never be moved. You, Lord, of your goodness have made my hill so strong. You turned your face from me, and I was distressed. When I cried unto you, O Lord, you and came to my Lord most humbly. Then I cried unto you, O Lord, and came to my Lord most humbly. What profit is there in my bloodshed if I go down into the pit? Shall the dust give thanks unto you, or shall it declare your faithfulness? Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. O Lord, be my helper. You have turned my lamentation into dancing. You have put up my sackcloth and girded me with gladness. Therefore shall my heart sing of your praise without ceasing. O Lord my God, I will give thanks unto you forever. In you, O Lord, have I put my trust. Let me never be put to confusion. Deliver me in your righteousness. Bow down your ear to me and make haste to deliver me, and be my strong rock and house of defense, that you may save me. For you are my strong rock and my castle. Be also my guide and lead me for your name's sake. Draw me out of the net that they had laid secretly for me, for you are my strength. Into your hands I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me. O Lord, O God of truth, I have hated those who hold to worthless vanities, and my trust has been in the Lord. I will be glad and rejoice in your mercy, for you have considered my trouble and have known my soul in adversities. You have not shut me up in the hand of the enemy, but have set my feet where they may walk at liberty. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with heaviness, and also my soul and my body, for my life has grown old with heaviness, and my years with mourning. My strength fails me because of my iniquity, and my bones are consumed. I have become a reproof among my enemies, all my enemies, but especially among my neighbors. My acquaintances are afraid of me, and those who see me in the street shrink from me. I am utterly forgotten, as a dead man out of mind. I have become like a broken vessel. For I have heard the whispering of the multitude, and fears on every side, while they conspire together against me and take their counsel to take away my life. But my hope has been in you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God. My time is in your hand. Deliver me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me. Show your servant the light of your countenance, and save me for your mercy's sake. Let me not be confounded, O Lord, for I have called upon you. Let the ungodly be put to confusion and be put to silence in the grave. Let the lying lips be put to silence, which cruelly, disdainfully, and despitefully speak against the righteous. Oh, how plentiful is your goodness, which you have laid up for those who fear you, and which you have prepared for those who put their trust in you, even before the children of men. You hide them in the secret place of your presence from those who conspire against them. You keep them in your refuge from the strife of tongues. Thanks be to the Lord, for he has shown me marvelously great kindness in a strong city. But when I was afraid, I said in my haste, I am cast out of the sight of your eyes. Nevertheless, you heard the voice of my prayer when I cried unto you. O love the Lord, all you his saints, for the Lord preserves those who are faithful and plenteously repays the proud. Be strong, and he shall establish your heart. All you that put your trust in the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the second book of Kings, beginning with the 20th chapter, the first verse. In those days, Hezekiah became mortally ill. And Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, came to him and said to him, This is what the Lord says, Set your house in order, for you are going to die and not live. Then he turned his face to the wall and prayed to the Lord, saying, Please, Lord, just remember how I have walked before you wholeheartedly and in truth, and have done what is good in your sight. And Hezekiah wept profusely, and even before Isaiah had left the middle courtyard, the word of the Lord came to him, saying, Return and say to Hezekiah, the leader of my people, This is what the Lord, the God of your father, says. The God of your father, David, says, I have heard your prayer. I have seen your tears. Behold, I am going to heal you. On the third day, you shall go up to the house of the Lord. And I will add 15 years to your life. And I will save you in the city from the hand of the king of Assyria. And I will protect the city for my own sake and for my servant David's sake. Then Isaiah said, take a cake of figs. And he took it and placed it on the inflamed spot. And he recovered. Now Hezekiah said to Isaiah, what will be the sign that the Lord will heal me, and that I will go up to the house of the Lord on the third day? Isaiah said, this shall be the sign to you from the Lord, that the Lord will perform the word that he has spoken. Shall the shadow go forward 10 steps or go back 10 steps? So Hezekiah said, it is easy for the shadow to decline 10 steps, no, but have the shadow turn backward 10 steps. Then Isaiah the prophet called out to the Lord, and he brought the shadow on the stairway back 10 steps by which it had gone down on the stairway of Ahaz. At that time, Barodash Baladan, a son of Baladan, king of Babylon, sent letters and a gift to Hezekiah because he heard that Hezekiah had been sick. And Hezekiah listened to them and showed them all his treasure house, the silver, the gold, the balsam oil, the scented oil, the house of his armor, and everything that was found in his treasuries. There was nothing in the house nor in all his realm that Hezekiah did not show them. Then Isaiah the prophet came to King Hezekiah and said to him, what did these men say, and from where have they come to you? And Hezekiah said, they have come from a far country, from Babylon. Isaiah said, what have they seen in your house? So Hezekiah answered, they have seen everything that is in my house. There is nothing among my treasuries that I have not shown them. Then Isaiah said to Hezekiah, hear the word of the Lord. Behold, the days are coming when everything that is in your house and what your fathers have stored up to this day will be carried to Babylon. Nothing will be left, says the Lord. And some of your sons who will come from you, whom you will father, will be taken away, and they will become officials in the palace of the king of Babylon. And Hezekiah said to Isaiah, the word of the Lord which you have spoken is good. For he thought, it is not good. Is it not good if there will be peace and security in my days? Now the rest of the acts of Hezekiah and all his might, and how he constructed the pool and the conduit and brought water into the city, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the kings of Judah? So Hezekiah lay down with his fathers, and his son Manasseh became king in his place. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense, and he will be my Savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation, and on that day you shall say, give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the peoples. See that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud in heavens of Zion, ring out your joy, for the great one of you, as the Holy One of Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, beginning with the 11th chapter, the first verse. Now the apostles and the brothers and sisters who were throughout Judea heard that the Gentiles also had received the word of God. And when Peter came up to Jerusalem, the Jewish believers took issue with him, saying, "You went to uncircumcised men and ate with them." But Peter began and explained at length to them in an orderly sequence, saying, "I was in the city of Joppa praying, and in a trance I saw a vision, an object coming down like a great sheet lowered by four corners from the sky, and it came to where I was. And I stared at it and was thinking about it, and I saw the four-footed animals of the earth, the wild animals, the crawling creatures, and the birds of the sky. I also heard a voice saying to me, 'Get up, Peter, kill and eat.' But I said, 'By no means, Lord, for nothing unholy or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' But a voice from heaven answered a second time, 'What God has cleansed, no longer consider unholy.' This happened three times, and everything was drawn back up into the sky. And behold, at that moment, three men who had been sent to me from Caesarea came up to the house where we were staying, and the Spirit told me to go with them without misgivings. These six brothers also went with me, and we entered the man's house, and he reported to us how he had seen the angel standing in his house and saying, 'Send some men to Joppa and have Simon, who is also called Peter, brought here, and he will speak words to you by which you will be saved, you and all your household.' And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell upon them just as he did upon us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he used to say, 'John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit.' Therefore, if God gave them the same gift as he also gave to us after believing in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could stand in God's way?" When they heard this, they quieted down and glorified God, saying, "Well then, God has also granted to the Gentiles the repentance that leads to life." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God. Take not your Holy Spirit from us. Grant us, Lord, not to be anxious about earthly things, but to love things heavenly. And even now, as we live among things that are passing away, to hold fast to those things, to hold fast to those that shall endure through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the King eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires. Incline our hearts to keep your law, and guide our feet into the way of peace, that, having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross, that everyone may come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise not only with our lips but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us as well knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.